Holiday magic alive and well in Dover. This is a community effort, and so many people signed up to volunteer. Organizers had to ask half of them to please wait until next year's feast to help.
7 o'clock this morning, the three of us, Mark and Derek, we have cooked 200 pounds of turkeys, 100 pounds of mashed potatoes, 30 pounds of green beans, about 30 pounds of stuffing.
So what do you get when you blend a trio of chefs, an army of volunteers, the financial support of nearly 40 businesses on the day before Thanksgiving in a lovely Dover restaurant? The answer is gratitude.
I'm thankful for just my family being healthy, and we're on the right track to a new start.
To walk away after putting this on and seeing the impact that you have on so many people, it's a great way to enter the holiday weekend. For me, personally.
Jeff Romer and his friend Mike Steinberg started this community-based Thanksgiving celebration 3 years ago and served 140 guests from area nursing homes, the Dover Children's Home, and shelters. This year, the guest list has doubled, and this restaurant owner is delighted. Rilla Joven will be 85 on Christmas Eve. This feast makes her reminisce about the days when she cooked for the entire family.
Yeah, I used to make a Hawaiian salad in the winter, for the holidays.
This tenor from Dover High School brought his pipes to the party. The holiday of giving thanks is in good hands in Dover.
You have to give back. That's the whole thing about you got to give back. You know, when I was growing up, my family always helped me out. It's time to give back. I always thought, that was always taught to me, and I always said I'll do that. That's what I really want to. I really enjoy doing it. It's a lot of fun. You walk out of it, you feel good.
You feel good. We should note Santa did make a cameo appearance at the restaurant today. He tells News 9 he's trying to get a jump start on his list, and well, sure, he had some pie as long as he was there. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. Amy Covino, News 9.